Mother.
You bandit scum!
Mosquitoes kept you up all night, or what?
Shit! He's dead! The marauders are attacking enemy raid!
It's just one man. There's no danger for me.
So he escaped. No problem. No intruder can stay here in our forest forever.
There he is!
This place is so great. Quiet. I wish it was always like this. Ha!
matter with you?
Hey! The android! He's here!
Where are you? Your bandit is scum!
Sashka is damn lucky. Bonked one intruder in this.
Traitors up there!
Thank you.
And now he's on fast lane into the teacher's house and his house.
He's an instructor now.
That intruder was stopped. There were three of our guys around.
So what? Does that make hitting him from behind a big deal?
If it's such a small deal, then I bet you could do it too.
Just get the stick and hit the next intruder that comes with it.
He fancies the teacher's house so much.
I might do just...
You're down, bastard!
What's over there? Let's check it out. Huh?
Why do I have to waste my time here? Nothing even happens. Well, I guess the instructor knows what he's doing.
What?
It's just me after all. Not that I wanted there to be anything.
Who's that? The shadow over there.
Hey, what is that? See? Down there?
Huh?
The intruder is here, guys!
That Sashka is damn lucky. Bumped one intruder in the head, and now he's on fast lane into the teacher's house and his vows.
He's an instructor now.
But he earned that. Just as soon as he was stopped, there were three other guys around.
So what? Does that make hitting him from behind a big deal?
If it's such a small deal, then I bet you could do it too. Just get the stick and hit the next intruder that comes with it if you fancy teacher's house so much.
I might do just that. And you, don't you feel jealous guarding the house and never even entering it? Jorka's always there, but is he better than us?
Boy, you are salty. Zorka's a guard there, a damn honor guard. He can't even sit down for a moment. The others are making vows while he stands at attention. What do you think Vitya is going to stand in the corner for?
No idea. Roman will decide that when he's back. Why?
I just think we should have put him there. It wasn't he who told the lie, it was a drifter. Besides, Olga distracted him.
I'm learning all right.
In any case, he only makes it worse for himself. If the police catch him, they'll just pin him to a tree.
That reminds me, why don't they respect the teacher?
He told them in the end that they shouldn't just kill him. Yes, but the pirates think that protecting their friends, as the teacher has told them before, is the important part. And what he told them to end is just...
Something died. I guess I'll go wash the sweat off.
some bandits came here or something. Nothing ever happens when it's my watch. Instructors are overreacting. Who cares if there are a couple of drifters around?
Go mushroom hunting now. It's high season and I'm stuck like God here. Are you riding there?
Sure I am. What else can I do?
Good. Right. I will be brave. I will protect my friends. I will never bully the girls. I will be brave. I will protect. I will never bully. Sure it is enough?
Yeah, right, it's so going to say it. But this thing isn't going to say a word anyways.
Why? Even you can talk, and it's much smarter than you, that's for sure.
Hello?
Smart. I told you we should have just killed them. They aren't going to talk anyway.
Just kill them? Ever tried hanging on one of their posts with wolves nibbling at your feet? They have a lot to answer for.
Aren't you taking this a little too personal? You sure don't look like you've been on a post.
I haven't, but my friends have.
Now continue these two fuckers after the break. How many fingers did he have left?
Uh-huh.
Lobar. He's all dried up, but I'm sure. And there's Log. And the other boys from the third barrack. Where the hell are these fuckers hiding?
Don't worry. The two we caught will talk soon.
Oh, these fuckers never talk.
This will.
Any green horde?
Oh, it's really weird. Them boys are taking so long there. Should have started cutting fingers off long ago. Made them spill their guts by now.
Should start cutting heads off, not fingers. Those fuckers are hardcore.
Shit, this is the pits. Gotta keep both eyes peeled all the time, and that's just exhausting.
They're more used to hiding in the forest.
What do we do now?
Fuck.
How do you feel?
What are we even doing here? Just shit. Place. This place is bad news. Any greenhorn can get me here. What are we even doing here? Just shit. Place. This is just pointless. Pointless, I say. Fuck. What are we even doing here? It's a shit place. This place is bad news. Any greenhorn could get me here. This is just pointless, I say. What are we even doing here? It's a shit place. This place is bad news. Any greenhorn could get me here. What are we even doing this is here? Just pointless. It's a shit pointless place. I say. This place is bad news. Fuck. Any greenhorn could get me here. Pointless, I say.
Freaks and mutants.
Fuck.
What are we even doing here?
What are we even doing?
Such a shit.
This is just pointless. Pointless, I say. Fuck.
pointless. Any greenhorn can
pointless,
get
I say.
This place is bad news.
Fuck.
Any greenhorn can
what
get
What are we even
here?
Doing here?
This is a shit
pointless.
Place.
Point. Freeze, Drifter! So, we meet again? Though I bet you don't remember who dragged you out of the water. My name is Olga, by the way. Was it you fighting the Master of the Forest? Awesome. Our hunters had been staying away from him for years. Damn it. Sorry, teacher. The locks all rusted up. Your friend Alyosha is already at the dam. He said your colonel won't wait, so you don't have much time. Sorry, I can't take you there. At today's council session, the pirates moved to attack your train, but they had no right to even call one without me present. As usual, I need to go and sort this out. But I have a few minutes to give you some directions. You need a boat to get to the dam. And our pirates keep all the boats at their swamp camp. They are not the sharing kind. But that's no reason to attack. Nobody wants bloodshed, so just stay out of their sight. Take the road to the barricade. Go down to the swamp and find the dock. That's where Alyosha and I took the boat from. Teacher, forgive me. There are some left, but be careful. Well, Drifter, take care. And don't make me sorry I helped you people. Tell Alyosha I said hi. I'll stay a bit longer to tend to the grave of the teacher. Decided to relax a bit before the trip. That's a good idea. And I'm stuck in thought here. Once the master decided to haunt the vicinity, people all but stopped coming here, though they haven't forgotten. The teacher raised us all, taught us how to survive in the forest. If not for him, we'd all be long dead. So the girls used to come here every day, and the boys still make it from time to time. Even Roman does visit, though it was because of him that the teacher left back then. Most of us went on a trip down the river. There were just a few people left on duty in the camp. When we came back, we found it raided by bandits. It still pains me to remember the scene. Can't even describe it. Once we and the younger group were done crying, the teacher was digging the graves alone. The elder boys were nowhere to be seen. We helped the teacher with burying ours. It was dark already when the boys returned and sat around the campfire. Roman was so covered with blood, you could only see his eyes and teeth. Then they started talking. Tracking was easy. The bandits didn't even try covering their tracks. So the boys waited till they all got drunk in their camp and shot them with bows. Then Roman knifed the wounded like they were deer. The teacher just sat there listening. I can still see his chin tremble. And he didn't say anything. Anything at all. They understood what he meant anyway. Come morning, he was gone. To this church. At first, he wouldn't speak to anyone. But us girls kept checking up on him. Just to bring him some berries, or ask for advice. And gradually, he started speaking to us. Still, he was like a different man. So distant. He never talked to the older boys anymore, though he'd reply to their letters. And to the rest of us who'd keep visiting him, he would always say we had to become their conscience, keep them from becoming monsters. But how do you do that? And they didn't stop at that either. Started calling themselves pirates, made the floated lumber mill in the swamp their private HQ. Then, they started hanging bandits from the posts, calling them musts. One day they took about 10 bandits alive and used them to test all the boys. Made them kill the bastards. None of ours could do it. And they all got called cowards for that. And then got ostracized. That's how the pioneers came to be.